let us talk about Mahatma Gandhi. Why it is necessary to know about Mahatma Gandhi? What is so unique? He was unique in Indian history because we call him father of our nation, because he led a national movement for more than 20 years to make India free from the British rule. But Gandhi is not limited to India only. He is also a great thinker. Although his personality was such that the greatest of the world personalities have acknowledged his presence. Like, for instance, Albert Einstein has said that the future generation will scarcely believe that such a man like Mahatma Gandhi ever walked on this earth in flesh and bones. Why was he so unique? Because he led a very simple life. He devoted his total life for others, and he did not want anything for himself. He was not a king. He was not a moneyed man. He was not a very good speaker, but his voice was such, the power of his voice, his words were such that millions of Indians were moved by him. And not only Indians, but now after his death in 1948, if we look at the history of the world, and if we look at different movements which are taking place all over the world against tyrannical state and for democratizing different societies, we will find that most of them are inspired by Mahatma Gandhi. Whether it is a movement in Middle East, movement in Russia, movement in South Africa, movement in India and other countries, or even in the United States, like Martin Luther King, Nelson Mandela, there are many others in the last 60-65 years who have led movement of protest against the state, and all of them were inspired by Mahatma Gandhi. What was so unique in Mahatma Gandhi that he inspired so many persons? The first thing is that although he was the first modern representative of a democratic movement against the state, because I think he is in the 20th century, he was one of the first to mobilize human beings, to mobilize common men against the tyranny of the state in a unique manner. That is the first thing. Secondly, he not only mobilized people, but he introduced something new in mobilizing people. Because if you look at the history of the world, then you will find that most of the political changes which have happened in the history were by the use of violence in one way or the other way. Gandhi is the first one who at such a large scale has tried to provide a movement its strength in non-violence. He was the first one who applied non-violence as a political strategy. As a man of conviction, he thought that non-violence is the ultimate weapon to fight against injustice. So he introduced non-violence on a larger scale, and he led many movements, first in South Africa and later on in India, in making non-violence a potent weapon of protest. That is the uniqueness. He was not only non-violent in its deeds for others, he was also a man who tried to transform himself. That was another important aspect of his philosophy, that while resorting to many methods of non-violence application, he also wanted that the person or the protester who is trying to use non-violence in his war, he should also change himself. So the war or the fight is not against the enemy, whatever enemy you may call it, but he did not term them as enemy, but also against oneself and the evils inside. So his protest has two dimensions, outer dimensions and inner dimensions. That is again his unique contribution, because he believed that the Satyagrahi, he called his movement Satyagraha. So that Satyagraha, which is adherence to truth, is not possible by an ordinary person. It is possible by only those protesters who also adhere to certain principles, basic ethical principles. If we follow those ethical principles, then only we can be a very good Satyagrahi.